Hi, this is Kim White with the My Sexy Business team. I'm excited to be with you today for today's topic, what is a sexy life? You know, our tagline for our business is we are here to help you create a sexy business for a sexy life. But if you don't know what that means, it won't do you a lot of good. So let's talk about what it means. The sexy life that we talk about is different for every person. It's not a generic definition. It's a specific definition. What are your priorities? What are your desires? What is it that you want your life to look like? Now, I want you to step back a minute and I want you to think about what your life would look like on the perfect day, but on an ordinary day. What would you want to be doing on just any given day? Not the big, you know, parties or events or the things that are, you know, major in your life. What do you want your everyday life to look like? Would it be more time with your kids? Would it be more time to serve? Would it be more time to work in your nonprofit? Would it be more time to, I want you to fill in the blank. Because here is the part about a sexy life that is wonderful, in my opinion. And that is, it is actually the freedom to do what it is that's a priority to you. Now, a sexy life can change over time. It changes, you know, during different seasons. When my boys were little, all I had as a priority was them. I wanted to spend as much time with them as I could because they were my priority. Now that, you know, I'm an empty nester, I still want to see my, you know, my children, but I also have an entirely different way and lifestyle because I'm not changing diapers and I'm not cooking 5 pounds of, you know, whatever to feed them. And I'm not doing the things that are required on a daily basis. So my sexy life may look different than your sexy life. And both of our sexy lives may look different to someone else. I want you to think about your heart's desires. What is it that you really desire out of life? What are your priorities? I want you to list all these things and actually put them in writing. The clearer you can become on your priorities, the clearer you can become on what you want things to look like. Take away the time and the money with both of those things. Take away the responsibility things for just a minute. And think about what you want your everyday life to look like. Would you wake up at 6 every morning? Would you sleep until 8 every morning? Would you exercise every day? Would you spend time meditating and praying? Would you, you know, make sure that you are fixing your children's breakfast? Would you make sure you're cooking your husband's dinner? Would you rather be out, you know, buying dinner at a restaurant? What is it that your average everyday life would look like if there were no time and money constraints? I want you to think about that, and then I want you to compare it to what your priorities are. Because if your priorities don't line up with what you're wanting, you've got to figure out where the incongruency is. You've got to figure out where it doesn't match. Remember, it's not a thing of money and time while you're making a plan. You have to start somewhere, and that's where you start. You start where things are timeless and there's no money involved. You have plenty of money, you have plenty of time. What would you do? That sexy life is available to you if you do certain things. You have to be, you know, clear about what it is you want. You have to get clearer and clearer on that you're responsible for creating that life. This is a no excuse zone. It's very difficult to ever have what you really want as long as you are still making excuses of one kind or another. I can't because, I don't because, whatever it is, just take it away. No more excuses. And this is not a making you feel bad because you don't have what you want in life. This is a let's figure out what you want in life and figure out how to get that for you. We really are here to help you with this process. We're here to help you create sexy businesses with streams of income to support a sexy life. But you know, if someone showed up today with a time machine and a checkbook and said you can have all the time you want and all the money you want, my guess is most of us wouldn't even know what to ask for. We might ask for something, you know, that isn't really congruent with what we want because we've never stopped long enough to get clear about what we want. So that's the challenge from this topic and this podcast. What is it that you want? My sexy life is not the same as your sexy life. What would you do on an ordinary, everyday basis if you could do anything you wanted? And I want you to like spend some time imagining that, because sometimes when you ask for something and you get it, it's not what you expected. So I'm going to also ask you to spend some time with what you're asking for. Spend some time thinking about it. If you slept in every day, let's say that was your goal or that was the thing you thought would make it a sexy life, and you spent every day sleeping in, would it really make you happy? Or is it because you're exhausted right now and you need some time off, it would help you get caught up on some rest and then you wouldn't enjoy it anymore? I want you to think about those things and I want you to write them down. I can't stress enough that getting clear about what you want is a huge, huge step toward getting what you want. You might take it lightly and you might make the excuse, well, I don't have time for that. Well, then you're never going to have time to get what you want. Because if you can't get clear on what you want, you're going to continue to get muddied waters in what you're asking for. And if you waffle, well, I kind of want this, but I kind of want that, and I'm going to waffle back and forth, there's no way for you to get what you want when you're waffling. Now, waffling and wanting more than one thing are not the same. If I waffle on, I want to be full-time at home, or I want to be a full-time traveler, and I go back and forth, that's waffling. But I want both. I want to be at home, you know, doing what I want to do at home, and I want to travel. That's not incongruent with my sexy life. That's actually completely congruent with what I want. But it's not waffling. You have to look at what you want and make sure that you're not waffling back and forth. You get traveling and then you say, oh, I just want to be home. And then you're home and, oh, I just want to be traveling. That's not what I'm talking about. Being consistent in what you want, clear in what you want, no excuses in what you want. That's what creates possibility. I appreciate you being on with us for our podcast. These first 101 podcasts are going to be all about a foundation of what we are talking about, sexy business and sexy life. So I appreciate you listening, and our topic for our next episode is staying in your lane. Thank you for being with me today. This is Kim White with the My Sexy Business team.